Hello! In this 12-minute video, I want to show you how anyone can create a simple 3D item and sell it on Roblox. My name is Nachos, I am not a 3D artist, and this is the perfect video for folks new to modeling, 3D art, and user-generated content on Roblox. Before continuing, we'll be using the following free software: Blender, Roblox Studio, and a web browser of your choice. While it can help to be familiar with all of these applications, this video will go through each and every step along the way and include all our available resources in the description. Keep in mind that this video only touches the surface of each step in the 3D creation process, and this video only covers the process of creating the most basic avatar item, a rigid accessory. This video does not cover creating more complicated avatar items like clothing or bodies. And last important information before we get started, creating on Roblox is free, but the last step of getting your asset on the marketplace requires a premium Roblox subscription, an upload fee, and a publishing advance. All user-generated content on Roblox must meet Roblox's technical and community policies. And, as always, resources for all of these are in the description. Now, let's get started. For our avatar item, we'll be creating a very simple treasure chest backpack using the same steps found in our Box Modeling 101 guide. If you are new to Blender, I recommend first checking out our article on introductory modeling in Blender by our resident 3D artist Schlimpf. Since all of these instructions are available in much more detail in the article, we'll be going through each modeling step very quickly and I'll cover a broad overview, but feel free to pause, rewind, or refer to Schlimpf's article to review any steps. In a new Blender project, delete everything besides a cube. To make the cube more horizontal, select the cube and then press S to scale. Press Y to scale by the Y axis. Switch to Edit Mode. In Edit Mode, we'll primarily be using three basic modeling techniques: extrusion, loop and cut, and segmentation. Select the top face of the cube and press E to extrude with your mouse. Click to confirm. Create the rounded top of your chest by selecting the front and back top edges with Line Select. Use Ctrl or Command B to use the Bevel tool and open the context menu. In this menu, set the number of segments to 6 and enable clamp overlap. The Bevel tool can sometimes squish vertices very close together without combining them. Use the Vertices Select and press A to select all vertices. Right-click and select Merge Vertices by Distance and set the distance to 0.01. Do a quick check to make sure your geometry has not changed after merging vertices. Next, apply insets to the left and right faces of the chest. Using the Face Select tool, hold Shift and select the two faces on both sides. Press I for inset and drag the mouse to adjust how much to inset a new face. Make the inset about the size of your segmentations. Right-click and select Extrude along Normals. Now use the mouse to adjust how much to extrude the face inward. Next, make the same metal edges to the front and back of the chest. Select the entire chest, press Ctrl or Command R to use the Loop Cut tool. Make sure the loop cut is vertical, then double-click to create a seam in the middle. In the context menu, change the number of cuts to 2. And with the two cuts still selected, press S to scale and Y to scale along the Y axis. Extend the cuts until they match the metal edges of your chest. Using the same technique, select the chest and press Ctrl or Command R to loop cut. This time, make a horizontal cut. To straighten this new cut, select the entire line, press S for scale, Z for Z axis, and 0 as the value. To ensure that the cut is in the same position as the metal border on the sides, enable the magnet snapping feature. Then set it to vertices and position the bottom cut to the bottom border. It should snap into place. Select the second cut and straighten this cut with S for scale, Z for axis, and 0 for value. Then position this cut to the top to match your border spacing. Next, create extrusions on the front, top, and back of your chest. Using the Face Select, hold Option or Alt to select our adjacent front faces, then select the metal borders by shift-clicking. Right-click, select Extrude Faces along Normals, and extrude your faces inward to match your borders. The chest is still missing the contiguous metal borders on the top sides of the chest. Use the Face Select tool to select the three faces on each side, and press X to delete these faces. Perform this operation on both sides of your model. Starting on any side, carefully select two opposing edges on the missing face. Right-click and select New Face from Edges to create a top and bottom flap of the metal border. Repeat this step with vertical edges and complete the metal border. Then repeat all these steps on the other side of the model. Just like our previous steps, create new faces for the top and bottom flaps of your metal border. Then complete the border by filling in the face between the left and right lines. At this point, modeling is complete for the basic treasure chest, and you can move on to texturing. Texturing is the process of defining the surface area of your 3D model. This is a very important aspect of the final appearance of your object. Typically, texturing can be an in-depth process requiring additional software. This video only covers one of the simplest ways to apply a basic texture in texture painting in Blender. Alternatively, you can also try generating a texture for your object in Studio with Texture Generator. This can provide an extremely quick alternative to texturing your assets, though it's recommended to learn more about the texturing process so you can have a more precise control over your item's appearance. Check out our resources on texturing in the description. Now, onto basic texturing in Blender. In Edit Mode, select your object. At the top, navigate to the UV dropdown and select Smart UV Project. For our specific use case, add a small island margin value. In the bottom right property panel, navigate to the red Material tab and select New. Click on the dot for base color and add a new image texture. Name this something specific and then set a basic color. To make the texture painting process easier later, choose a color for the metal edges, like a light gray. Next, head over to the Texture Paint tab. If you only see a blank light gray canvas on the top left, make sure to go back to the Layout tab and ensure that your object is selected before navigating back to the Texture Painting tab. In Texture Paint, you can paint directly on an object in either window. Open up the tool slider on the top right of either window to access your brush settings. Feel free to test some settings that work best with you. Keep in mind you can hold F and move your mouse to adjust the size of your cursor. Because Blender automatically laid out our UV atlas, it's not easy to immediately tell where the 2D atlas on the left maps to the surface of the 3D object on the right. Pick a color and a small brush size and make marks on all of the wooden base areas of the 3D chest object. This helps identify those surfaces on the 2D atlas to paint later. Take extra care to not accidentally color any of the metal border of your chest. Also make sure to mark all the main surfaces of your left and right sides. When marking all of your main surfaces, make sure not to accidentally color the edges of your border chest. Double check that you marked all the front, back, left, and right individual surfaces. If you make a mistake, use Ctrl or Command Z to undo. Also remember, you can hold F and adjust your brush size with your mouse. This could be handy for smaller areas. Now you can focus on filling in these spaces. In the left window, use the tool slider on the top right of the window to access your brush settings. To ensure accurate brush strokes, change your fallout shape to make sure the brush has hard edges. To help navigate, you can also expand the window, zoom in with the mouse wheel, and click and drag with the mouse wheel to move around. Find all the marked areas of your 2D atlas and fill in the squares. Hold F and drag with your mouse to adjust the brush size, and make sure not to brush in any of the unmarked shapes of your atlas. The 3D representation on the right should update with your changes. Keep a careful eye on your texture updates and make sure to revert anything accidental. After making your first basic texture, feel free to experiment. Blender has a lot of texturing tools, and there are many techniques you can use and apply here for a more realistic or creative effect. After your texturing is complete, navigate to the Image dropdown at the top left and click Save. Navigate back to the Layout mode and preview your object. Make sure to select the Material Preview at the top right to see your texture. You can export your object at any time by selecting File, Export. Roblox supports FBX and GLTF formats. Use the following export settings. You can find these details on the Roblox documentation linked below. Keep in mind that if you're exporting FBX and you did not adjust your scene scale in Blender, set your transform scale to 0.01. Save your export somewhere locally, and we can move on to importing. In Studio, select Import 3D and select your file. The 3D importer shows a preview of your model file and alerts you to any general issues. If you're missing textures on your assets, you can still import the asset and upload the textures later as an image and assign the texture manually. Next, select Import to add the model to your workspace. Notice how your asset imports as a model containing a mesh part. The mesh part includes the mesh ID for the geometry and the texture ID for the assigned texture. Next, we need to start converting this to an accessory object. In the Avatar tab, open the Accessory Fitting tool. Select the part field and click the model you intend to convert. For this example, select the back type accessory. On the next screen, a bounding box appears that marks the maximum size and placement for the accessory. If the bounding box is red, the object is too large or out of bounds for that accessory type. Select the item and use the rotation, scale, and position tools to move the object to where it should attach to the character mannequin as an accessory. The bounding box turns blue when the accessory is within appropriate bounds. You can also preview the item on different character bodies in the accessory fitting tool preview. This is a good opportunity to check if your accessory looks correct on different body types. Once you're satisfied with how the accessory looks, you can generate your accessory object. Currently, if you intend to upload to the marketplace, rigid accessories must be generated as a legacy accessory. After generating, a new accessory object appears in your workspace. This is now a good opportunity to test your asset on a sample character. You can close the accessory fitting tool panel and drag your accessory to an open area of your project. In the Avatar tab, select the Rig Builder and add a character to your workspace. In the Explorer, drag and drop the accessory into your character model. The accessory should equip to the character's back. With the character model selected, navigate to the Avatar tab and select the Avatar Setup tool. A new panel populates with various avatar animations and customizations for your sample character. Test out some animations to see how the accessory moves with your character. If you need to make adjustments, you may need to run your model through the accessory fitting tool again, or even make your adjustments back in the modeling software you're using. After you're done testing, it's time to upload your avatar item to the marketplace. In the Explorer, right-click your accessory object and click Save to Roblox. A prompt appears where you must fill out the title and description of your item. Make sure to accurately describe your asset so users can easily find and discover your avatar item on the marketplace. In Content Type, check the Avatar Item selection to publish the item to the marketplace as an avatar asset. In Asset Category, select the type of accessory that best matches your item. A quick validation occurs to ensure your item is marketplace ready. When everything's ready, you can now publish your asset with an upload fee. For more information on fees, see the resources in the description. After uploading, your asset may take up to 24 hours to moderate. After moderation is complete, you can set your item for sale on the Creator dashboard on a browser. Navigate to Creations, Avatar Items, Accessories, and filter by Back Accessories to see your asset. On this page, you can update the title and description fields and configure the sale settings of your asset, such as setting your item to a limited, updating your item price, or setting location, and more. For up-to-date information on each of these fields, click the Learn More links or check out the resources in the description. Whenever you're ready to submit, select the Publish Item button to set your item on sale. For most items, a recoupable publish fee is required when publishing an asset to the marketplace. That's a wrap on creating and selling a basic item from scratch. Keep in mind that there are many, many ways to create 3D assets, and this video explores only the beginning of what you can create. I recommend taking a look at our description and additional resources from artists and advanced creators. Please continue experimenting and creating. If you found this content helpful or have any questions or feedback, please leave them in the comments below.